been taken to the woodshed once again. All right, my next guest directed the films Beyond the Valley of the Dolls, Vixens, and Beneath the Valley of the Ultra Vixens. He's one of the great cult directors of our time. Please welcome Russ Meyer. Now, help us out here. Not everyone here tonight has seen a Russ Meyer film. Maybe you could, for us, describe the experience one gets when watches a Russ Meyer film.
Well, I put out a film that has big bazooms and square jaws.
I see.
Tripped around. They're comedies. They're cartoons.
Mm-hmm.
A good example of that is Beyond the Valley of the Dolls, that film that I made at Fox, and Roger Ebert did the script, who is familiar to everybody here, I'm sure. He's the stout gentleman. Yeah.
he's the fat one. So
I didn't say that.
Yeah. Now, so that's right. You collaborated with Mr. Ebert on this movie. He did the writing. He wrote it.
That's correct. Yes.
All right. Now, these films, there's a certain theme in your movies. I'd say, you have an obsession with women's breasts. Is that fair?
I wouldn't say it's an obsession, but I care for them a great deal.
All right, fair enough. And this has been carried through in a lot of your work. There's been actually your film, your first film was the second movie ever to get an X rating, isn't that right?
The picture Vixen. The first mm-hmm. picture to get an X rating was Girl on a Motorcycle, starring Marianne Faithfull. It was a Warner Brothers picture.
Mm-hmm.
That's when they set up this Kara thing with the ratings. And Warners were so shocked, they just shelved the picture. But it was very good for me to go out with that first X rating. You know, there are X ratings and then there are triple X ratings, but this was an official category of the rating system run by the Hollywood hierarchy.
So it was a historical event, first X-rated
movie. Well, I don't know. It's just that we just made a ton of money. I mean, the film grossed in excess of $26 million, cost only $67,000 to make. And, you know, now that's when tickets were $1.50. You're looking at an $80 million picture.
Right.
Played for 58 weeks at State Street in Chicago. Very, very significant movie, yes.
Now, what would you say is the big difference between, say, your first X-rated movie and a lot of X-rated movies today?
Well, I don't put down anything else. I'm in favor of freedom insofar as what you put on the screen.
Mm-hmm.
They call them triple X. I hate the term, for example, hardcore. They're, mm-hmm. I think, films that are very much admired and likened by a wide sector of our audiences. I see nothing wrong with that. I'm upset when they are taken to task in courts. I've had my time in court with this Charles Keating. You're familiar with him, the mm-hmm. SNL guy. He mm-hmm. tried to bury me with Vixen. It was banned in the state of Ohio, and I spent a lot of money fighting him. And I know every noontime when I was working on Dolls, I'd get this horrendous call from my lawyer, Elmer Gertz, and say, burn all the posters, burn the trailers, and so forth. We've got to come up with new material. Fortunately, Justice Berger came up with a decision when Keating tried to get me into the Supreme Court by denying it.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I rejoice in Keating's position today. You know,
things have sort of turned around.
Yeah,
Isn't life sweet? Now we actually have a clip of Faster Pussycat Kill Kill. Now, do you want to set this clip up for us?
Probably this is the second most successful film I've made, largely because women like it. It stars a lady, incredible lady, Tora Sutana. We had a tour together in Paris just recently because the film is being opened up for the second time in video. And the French are extremely nostalgic about actresses and actors that are older.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they cared for Marlene Dietrich when she was 82 years of age, and now Tora is, of course, older now. It looks wonderful, and the adoration was very, very exciting. But here you see a film that it was made for, as most of my films, was relatively little money, but there's an awful lot of care and effort on my part, and the fact, too, that they live, they keep playing. They keep playing and playing, and they never cease. Now, this is a sequence in which Tura is doing away with a demented actor in this film, Faster Pussycat Kill Kill. His name is Dennis Bush. In reality, she's actually a stockbroker. But he was a very muscular man. And Tura is dealing with the family. She's got to get rid of all these people, and she decides that one way to get rid of him is deal with him by brutalizing him with a Porsche car.
All right, let's take a look at that. We're out of time right now, but we'll be right back with Paula Newby-Fraser. Thank you very much.